In this video, we are investigating two ways of implementing a list: dynamic arrays and linked lists. Dynamic arrays are used to implement Python built-in lists. Other languages, such as Java, provide linked list implementation too. So it is important to understand the difference between the two implementations. First, we will explore arrays and dynamic arrays. An array is a data structure that contains a group of elements. Typically, these elements are all of the same data type, such as float or strings. Arrays are commonly used in computer programs to organize data so that a related set of values can be easily sorted or searched. Arrays are stored in a contiguous block of memory, which allows quick retrieval of value via indexing, quick being in constant time. In many languages, arrays are indexable from 0 to n-1, where n is the size of the array. In other languages, such as MATLAB, the arrays are indexable from 1 to n. In this example, the array contains 9 elements. The first index is 0 and the last index is 8. Although we did not use arrays this term, arrays are extensively used in libraries such as NumPy. Arrays could be used to implement a list. In this case, we need a pointer to indicate the tail of the list. The tail is where the next element will be appended. To append the first element, for example 6, we assign 6 to the array at the position indicated by the pointer tail and then move the pointer tail to the next index on the right. We can keep adding following the same process, for example, the value 2, 5 and 3. At that point, the pointer points to an index which is out of bounds. It means that the list is full. Trying to add another value will raise an error. Using this implementation of a list, it is simple and fast to add and remove an element at the back of the list. However, it is restrictive, as the list has a maximum size that we cannot exceed. If the array is too small, we cannot store all of the elements. To counteract this restrictiveness of a too small array, we may be tempted to declare a very large array, but we may use only a small part of it. This leads to a waste of memory. Due to these issues, arrays are seldom used for implementing lists and dynamic arrays are used instead. A dynamic array allows the size of the array to be dynamically increased if more space is needed, or to be decreased depending on the amount of unused space in the array. Now that the original array is full and we need more space to add the value 1, we create a larger array. Usually, we double the size of the original array. Then, we copy the value from the original array to the new array. Finally, we can append the value 1 to the list. Again, after several append operations, the list may become full. Again, we double the size of the dynamic array, copy the value from one array to the other, and once this operation has been completed, we can append the value 0. Let's explore some of the operations that can be done on a list, and let's see what impact on performances the implementation has. First of all, let's remove an element somewhere within the list, for example, the third element. Having done so, there is a hole in the middle of the list, which breaks the data structure. Therefore, we need to shift all the following elements to the left in order to fill the gap. This is quite inefficient if we have many elements to shift. Finally, we must remember to update the pointer tail at the end of the list. On the other hand, removing the last element is very efficient. We just need to remove the element before the pointer tail from the array and then move the tail pointer to the left. In contrast, removing the first element is very inefficient. If the list contains n elements, we need to do n-1 shift to the left. Similarly, inserting an element at the front of the list is very inefficient. If the list contains n elements, we need to make n shift to the right before inserting the element and updating the end of the list pointer. Note that built-in lists in Python are based on dynamic arrays, and the values stored in the list is a reference to or address of the object, not the object itself. There is an alternative to the dynamic arrays called linked list. There are several advantages and disadvantages in using linked list, so it is important to know the strengths and weaknesses of this implementation. As opposed to an array, elements in the list are not stored in a contiguous block of memory. In addition, a node in the list is composed of two parts. One containing the value, for example 8, 5, 6 or 7, and the other containing the reference to the next element in the list. To traverse the list from the first element to the last, we need to follow the references one by one. This means that accessing an element at a given index is expensive, as you need to go through all the preceding elements in the list. The last element of the list is signaled by a special value in the reference to the next element. In Python, the value is none, and in Java, the value is null. Finally, we need a pointer to the front of the list, the head, and another to the end of the list, the tail. The linked list implementation takes more memory space than a dynamic array, as we need to store the reference to the next node. Depending on your system, it is 4 or 8 bytes per node. Although the nodes are not contiguous blocks of memory, we usually represent the list in a linear fashion. Let's explore some of the operations performed on a list. The first one is append, which adds an element at the end of the list. First, we create a new node, then we update the tail reference of the node to the new node, and finally update the tail pointer to point to the new node. Removing the first element in the list is also very efficient, especially compared to dynamic arrays. The main action is to update the head to its successor. Another efficient operation is to insert at the front of the list. The first step is to create a new node, containing the value to be inserted, then to make the new node point to the head of the list, and finally update the head pointer to the new node. Again, the linked list performs better than dynamic arrays. On the other hand, removing the last element of the list is far less efficient compared to dynamic arrays. First, we need two pointers, one to keep reference to the previous element in red, and one that will indicate which element to remove in green. Then we need to traverse the entire list until the green pointer is at the last element of the list. Once at the end of the list, we update the tail pointer to the red pointer, and then update the tail reference to the next element, the value none. You may have noticed that the inefficiency comes from accessing the penultimate element of the list. If the tail had a reference to its predecessor, the operation could be very fast. This inefficiency is resolved, at the expense of a higher memory usage, when using a doubly linked list. In a doubly linked list, a node has a reference to its predecessor and a reference to its successor. When removing an element in the middle of the list, again, the inefficiency for these operations comes from accessing the element. Once the element has been found, the operation is fast, only 3 steps. Make node 5 point to node 7, remove the pointer between node 6 and 7, and dispose of node 6. Similarly, for inserting an element in the middle of the list, the inefficiency comes from accessing the position where to insert the new value as shown here. The first step when inserting an element is to create an element, a new node, then access the node before the insertion point. This is the expensive part of the operation as you may have to traverse most of the list. Then make the new node point to the successor of the node referenced by the green pointer. And finally, make the node referenced by the green pointers point to the new node. It is important to know which data structure is most suitable for a given problem. So let's recap the strengths and weaknesses of each implementation. Accessing an element at a given position is faster when using dynamic arrays. It is in constant time, O(1), as opposed to linear time, O(n), for linked list. When using a linked list, we usually want to access the first and last element. Searching for an element has the same performance for both implementations. If searching a collection of values is important, then a list is not the adequate data structure, whatever the implementation. Appending is very efficient for both implementations. You may object to that statement, as we have seen earlier that if the list is full, we need to create a larger dynamic array and then copy the n element from the original array to the new one. I agree, this is expensive. However, this case happens so rarely that on average, the operation is done in constant time. Insertion and deletion is linear for dynamic arrays, but constant time for a linked list. Again, you may say, wait a minute. We have seen that for a linked list, it is inefficient as we may need to traverse the entire list to remove an element. Surely, it is linear. And in some way, you are right. The complexity is O(n) if you need to search for the position in which to insert remove the node. In most cases, a linked list is never used that way. Usually, a linked list will insert at the front or at the back and delete at the front, not in the middle of the list. Therefore, it is considered constant time. This again highlights the importance of knowing your data structure. Pick the wrong one for your problem, and your application will suffer from poor performance.